This is the first part of a two-part video about a sample application that will show you how powerful desktop sharing is and how easy it is to implement as part of a Lync conversation. If you're interested in the code in this sample application, also see part two. In this part, I'll demonstrate desktop sharing and the sample application itself. See here a side-by-side view showing two computer desktops. On the left, you see the desktop of Dr. Krebs, a general practitioner. He's been looking at a chest x-ray and wants to consult with Dr. Forsyth, a radiologist, on the diagnosis. You see Dr. Forsyth's desktop on the right. Both are logged into Lync 2013 and both are running our sample application. They're going to look at the x-ray together, mark it up together, compare notes, and agree on a diagnosis, all as part of a Lync conversation. I want to give credit for the x-ray image I use in this video, which was copied from Wikipedia. First, we don't need the Lync client UI for this demonstration, so both of our doctors will minimize Lync. Watch Dr. Krebs choose Dr. Forsyth for this conversation and choose to share his desktop. Dr. Forsyth clicks Accept in the sample application to answer the call. Note that she doesn't click the toast to accept the call, she uses the sample application to accept the call. Dr. Krebs tells her he needs some help, selects Dr. Forsyth's name, and clicks Grant to give her control of his desktop. Dr. Krebs, the GP, then opens the x-ray and marks in blue the spot he thinks shows the patient's problem. Dr. Forsyth marks another spot herself using red and tells Dr. Krebs and IM that she thinks the issue of concern is actually at that spot. Dr. Krebs thanks Dr. Forsyth. Dr. Forsyth clicks Release Control to return control of Dr. Krebs's desktop and they end the conversation. This kind of sharing session can be played out in any industry, sharing just about any kind of data or application. Lync 2013 offers a lot of this functionality out of the box, but you can use the Lync 2013 SDK to customize it, as you saw here. If you want more information, download the sample itself from the MSDN code gallery and see part two of this video where I'll do a short code walkthrough in the sample and point to other sources of information.